Hi, Magic Image Hollywood readers. I'm Bree, and we're sitting down with noted actor Robert Picardo. And you are going to pretty much have a story about every genre that there is, because you really have done it all. TV, film.
Thank you, Bree. Don't forget Broadway.
Broadway, yes.
That's very kind. yes, I started my career as a theater actor in New York in my early 20s. Made my Broadway debut at 23 in a play called Gemini, where Danny Aiello played my dad. Remember Danny Aiello from Moonstruck? Mm-hmm. And then the following Broadway season, I played Jack Lemmon's son in a very coveted role in a play called Tribute, which we did very successfully on Broadway. And the play was remounted the following year. I know I'm dating myself, but let's say 1979 in Los Angeles. That's what brought me to California for a nice 8-week stay. And I believe since then, 8 weeks and about 31 years have gone by.
Fantastic. Do you miss Broadway?
Well, I've continued to do theater throughout my career on the West Coast. But yes, of course, I miss Broadway. My dream is to go back. I even have a little iron in the fire that I probably can't speak about. But I did a backers audition for a new Broadway musical last year. And there's a very good chance that we will be doing a full production of that. And if the show is good enough, then it will go to Broadway. So I have my fingers crossed.
So you've done all this stuff. You've obviously been around. If there's anything that wasn't related to acting that you could be doing, what would you be doing?
Other than talking to you?
Other than talking to me.
Well, gosh, I have silly hobbies. I grew up in an Italian family. I have two Italian cousins that are chefs, so I would say my main hobby is cooking.
Ooh, anything good?
Anything good? No, I make only bad food.
It's what
distinguishes
specialty?
Me, is it? you know, I cook mostly Italian food. But I cook other kinds of food, Thai Indian food, Thai Indian, some Chinese dishes. But I now have a wood-fired pizza oven, which was the dream of my life. So I make a lot of pizza, a big pizza party with a number of friends, and I work all night long. It's like, I don't know why, my friends sit and relax and eat, and I stand up for 4 hours and about 24 pizzas.
That's pretty impressive.
Yeah, so my friends are very lucky, I think is what I'm saying. my wife is a terrific cook, but she thinks she's got a good thing going, having a husband who likes to cook every night, uh-huh. So nobody's complaining.
I don't think I would complain if I were in your house either. So if you weren't an actor, then a
I would probably be a chef, yes, fantastic. Absolutely.
Are you a fan of any of the reality chef shows?
You know, I dabble in all of them. It's funny, I like to make things up myself rather than to take someone else's suggestions, but mm-hmm. but I do, and a lot of the on-camera guys are just terrific, but I don't remember any of their names. I love the guy with the bright blonde hair, the young guy with the sort of bleach blonde hair. He's terrific. Whoever you are, you know, we're talking about you. I met Giada De Laurentiis once because we have a very beautiful kitchen where I live, and she once did a photo shoot in my house. So I met Giada. She's very lovely, and I said, please. I had her cookbook. I said, would you please sign this to Robert? I understand you're a very good cook. Too bad you're married. which she did as a favor to me, and then I just flaunted that in front of my wife, just aww. To make my wife really appreciate how lucky she is.
I think she's very lucky. So let's reel it back towards acting, and let's have a story from one of your favorite shoots or a favorite experience.
Gosh.
Because you've done so much.
I will tell I'll tell a little story about Jack Lemmon. Obviously, for any young actor to have the experience of working with a legend like Jack Lemmon was an extraordinary experience. He had been at the time we worked together. He had already been a major Hollywood star for over 25 years. I was all of 23, 24 years old. He was very gracious and kind to me. But the story I'll tell, even though there were many other stories that are probably more respectable than this one, but while the show had been running several months on Broadway, we used to try to make each other laugh. His character was a real sort of a tap dancer, not a real tap dancer, but he just was very fun-loving and laughed a lot and brought a lot of joy to people. My character, who was his son from a divorce, was resentful of the fact that he was so happy-go-lucky because I felt he hadn't you know, paid enough attention to me growing up or whatever. I don't want to give the whole play. But in any case, I had to be very serious in Poker Face, whereas Jack would, his character was also trying to make me laugh, but he would play tricks on stage, and I would play tricks back. So one night, the prop man had given me, how should I say this discreetly, a dirty picture.
Okay.
A man and a woman doing unspeakable things to each other, and a little picture about this big. And we decided to put that picture in a photo album that I was looking at on stage in front of a whole Broadway audience. And so I'm sitting there looking at the photo album. Jack's character is standing over here. He can't see what I'm looking at. But what he's supposed to do in the play is he sees me holding up a picture. Again, he has to come around to see what the picture is. And he's supposed to come around and look at the picture and say, "Oh, you never knew your grandmother, did you?" And that was the line. I can imagine with that picture in your hand, that was an interesting line. Right before that, he said to me, you know, his character is trying to, you know, get me interested in hanging out with him. He says, "What do you want to do? We could go to the park, we could go to the museum, we could catch a movie. What would you like to do?" Mm-hmm. That's the line that comes right after this. So anyway, I'm looking at this dirty picture. Jack comes around, he looks at it, and he gives me this look. This look like, "Okay, kid, you want to dance, huh? You want to fool with the master." So he gives me this look. And he doesn't say anything. He just goes, "Oh, you never knew your grandmother, did you?" And he looks and he gives me a look, and then he goes, "Okay, so what should we do? We could go to a movie. We could go to the museum. We could come back and look at more pictures of your grandmother." and he says that trying to make me laugh.
Right.
But I don't laugh. But the rest of the cast, who's gathered off stage to watch this, they all laugh. So this big laugh comes in from the wings, and that makes Jack laugh. So everyone was laughing except for the audience and me.
But you stayed in character.
Poker faced to the end.
That's excellent. So now that you've had this career and you've worked with people like that, what do you think, what would you advise young actors today? Or you're a father, what kind of advice do you give your daughters about success? What makes success?
I think, just to quote Mr. Lemon one last time, someone to have his level of success and maintain such a grace in the way he dealt with his success and to be so encouraging to me, to a younger generation, I think that the best thing you can do once you achieve any level of success is to pay it forward as much as you can and to be as gracious and easy to work with as with other actors, young and old, as you can be. Because there are so many good actors out there that any time an actor gets a job, it's really a gift. Mm-hmm. You know, I think the world could do without any particular actor. And I think that no matter how famous you become, and I think this applies all the way up the ladder, if God has been good to you enough to give you these opportunities, then I think that the way you give back is to do the best work you can. And to just be kind and easy to work with other people, rather than a jerk and a diva. Just my opinion. Now, had I been much more attractive, I probably would have been a jerk or a diva. But I think that if you're really good looking, I think you can get away with being a jerk or a diva. If you look like a shoe salesman or a guy who works at the bank, you gotta be nice. That's my real advice. My daughters, of course, are very beautiful, so they're, you know, maybe they'll turn out to be divas, but
I don't. Do either of them want to be in the industry? Are they in the industry?
Both of my daughters are very interested in being behind the camera. My younger one in being a producer. My older one goes to a very prestigious art school and is interested, has already done internships in the art department on successful television shows. And is looking forward to either being in art direction or animation. So yes, they both like being on sets and grew up on sets.
I would imagine they definitely had their fair share of set experiences.
But just to finish your question, I think that as far as giving advice to a young actor, learn your craft, study. It takes quite a bit of self-discipline, I think, to be in the entertainment industry because it's so unstructured, especially when you're young and you're trying to get.
Do you think it's still a good industry, or do you think there's so much?
I think, again, I hate to sound like an old guy who talks about how much the industry has changed. It is much tougher now, I think, than when I It feels sort of less democratic than ever. Yeah. We all know that about the shrinking middle class actor. For there's the handful of stars at the top who make great amounts of money.
Right.
And then it seems like there's a big pool of actors working for scale or minimum at the bottom, and a shrinking sort of middle class. So I think that it has gotten tougher. I think that. Now that we used to have many, many employers, many independent companies, now with all of the merging and all that, they're like a handful, they're like five major employers.
Right.
And I think that makes it, also makes it more difficult and more competitive for young actors. So, but I think that, talent always succeeds.
Mm-hmm.
I think if you stay disciplined, work hard, learn your craft, and then hopefully, have a little luck once in a while.
Yeah.
You'll do fine.
So what's next for you? What's coming up?
Well, I've had a nice beginning to the year. I'm about to go to Canada on Monday to star in Beethoven Saves Christmas. Beethoven the Giant Dog.
Yes.
That's actually Beethoven calling me right now, off camera. All right, these things happen in a real moment, in a real interview. Somebody off camera, their phone goes off. I put mine on vibrate.
As long as it's not mine.
There have been five Beethoven movies. The last one was called Beethoven's Fifth, which I think is funny.
Mm-hmm.
They're very charming family movies, and I'm playing like the third or fourth lead. I'm the bad guy.
Ooh.
The funny bad guy, we hope. In Beethoven Saves Christmas, which will be out this Christmas. I encourage you all to go out and buy a copy, even though I haven't made the movie yet. I just, in the last week, I guest starred on No Ordinary Family,
the
ABC movie and a television series with Michael Chiklis. Mm-hmm. And I've also recently completed a low-budget indie called End of the Road, which is a genre, kind of a horror, but funny horror movie.
And so definitely still very much working.
Still working, and I have two movies coming out this year. One called The Legends of Nathaya, also a family movie. And on the Sci-Fi Channel, I did a movie called Morlocks, which is sort of based on the famous The Time Machine.
Mm-hmm.
So yes, things have still been busy.
That's good.
And that is good.
So if you could go back and redo any project or create any project for yourself, what would still be in the pipeline? What would you still want to do or redo?
That's always tough. I'm very anxious. As I said, my dream is to go back to Broadway. I'd love to be, to create a role in a Broadway musical, so I have my fingers crossed for that. There's still some great theater roles I'd like to do. I'd love to play Willie Loman in Death of a Salesman. That's a goal. It would be fun. The play I did with Jack Lemmon, Tribute, years ago, to go back and play the father. I had that experience with my first Broadway show, Gemini. I went back and played Danny Aiello's part in the musical version of the play. After doing 400 and some performances as the son, to go back 27 years later and play the father was a very cool sort of circle of life experience.
Yeah, absolutely.
So to do that, I've been talking with a regional theater producer about doing Tribute and playing the father this time around. That would be a lot of fun.
Any dream cast to surround you?
I haven't gotten that far. That would be great.
Still in the initial.
I don't know. Yeah, I don't know. Still in its initial stages. Beyond that, to continue cranking out pizzas for my friends, to continue to be married to my gorgeous wife. This is our 27th year of marriage. To have my kids be nice and successful and not need them to give me money once they're adults. All sorts of things I aspire to.
I have parents who aspire to the same thing.
I guess we all do. I finally become a parent.
Yes. Okay. Well, before we wrap it up, you are...
I also continue to do some appearances for science fiction conventions.
That's right. You're
Star Trek
you're
conventions
heavily
around the world, so I will be going... Last year I went to Europe 3 times.
Oh, wow.
For science fiction conventions. This year I will go to Germany again in August. So... the wonderful thing about science fiction fans is they are the most loyal fans
they
in the world.
Fantastic.
And they enjoy meeting actors that they've enjoyed in different programs. I
And how neat to be part of a franchise like that.
Well, I was not only starred on one of the Star Trek series for 7 years, I starred in our competitor, Stargate Atlantis, for a year.
I was going to ask, how does that work?
Well, you know, it's you feel a little like you're changing
team?
Allegiances. But
yeah.
Now I want to be in something Star Wars that I can win the trifecta, because then I will have hit all three.
All the majors.
All the majors. So if you're out there, George.
Hey, I heard there's stuff coming.
Well, you know, I could just do a voice on Clone Wars. Yeah. That would technically qualify. Then I will have hit all three of the star-studded franchises.
I think that's a great goal. So I was going to wrap it up by just asking, we're in the midst of award season. You are an Emmy-nominated actor.
I am, yes.
And
I was.
You were. But any predictions? Anything
oh,
coming
gosh.
After the Oscars?
You know, I don't know if it's tasteful to predict. I've been very... I loved several of the Oscar-nominated mm-hmm. movies. Colin Firth, his performance is not only extraordinary in The King's Speech, he's overdue. He's yeah. just the kind of actor. He was brilliant in his nominated film last year, the title of which slips my mind, but he was also extraordinary in that. He's really one of our best, and I think he's due. Having said that, there are many other excellent performances. Christian Bale in The Fighter, extraordinary performance, you know, just completely unrecognizable from when you see him
mm-hmm.
in life. Quite an amazing performance, and I also think Natalie Portman in Black Swan, extraordinary performance, and she's really come into her own as a fully realized talent. For someone who started, I guess, acting when she was six.
Yeah, very young.
Anyway, there are many many of the movies and the performances this year are really, really great. So I can't say I'd be disappointed. If those particular ones didn't win, but they're real standouts, and you know, I'll be watching freezing up in the coldest part of Canada, watching the Academy Awards. So I'd like you to feel just a little bit sorry for me, and for the giant Saint Bernard.
Yes. We will. Hopefully, we'll still be 80 down here, and then
yeah. Well, you know what? I've been
makes
down here enjoying
makes
the warmth.
Appreciate it.
Makes me
Absolutely.
Appreciate it. Even more.
Well, thank you so much, Robert, for
sure.
talking to us.
My pleasure, Bree.
I think anybody who's had a career like yours, your advice is always insightful to aspiring people as well as people who have made it in the industry.
Well, thank you very much. I appreciate that, and I wish anyone watching good luck.
Fantastic. Thanks.
Thank you.